Hi, I'm Tim Reed with the Aconcagua Dulce News, and I'm here today with Ms. Shirley Cutler. Thanks for sitting down with me.
You're welcome.
So, what would you say got you into teaching? What inspired you?
Well, the inspiration I had is many, many years ago, women didn't have a lot of choice of what they were going to do. They were either going to be housewives or teachers or social workers. So there wasn't really a lot of choice. So that's how I got into teaching.
Really? What kind of education did you need back then?
I needed a BA in education, which I have.
Okay.
I went to school in Eastern Washington, and at that time my first job was teaching in an institution for really retarded adults and children. There was about 1,000 people in the institution, and they had bomb scares, and when they had bomb scares, everybody had to go underground. So the whole institution had a tunnel, a big tunnel underneath the institution. Everybody went underground, and that's where we started out. So one of my thinking was, when I was there, was if this is a real thing, and I come out, the whole world will be different because most of the people will be mentally retarded, and just a few of us will not be. Yeah.
Wow. So what sort of change has there been throughout these years that you teach? Like, has your teaching style evolved?
Well, one of the things, the institution, children that have mental handicaps now stay at home and go to regular school. They could go in special ed classes. Other changes that I've seen a lot of different changes. We had very small classes at first, and now we have huge classes. I would title one teacher, and so we emphasize reading. Kids that need special help with reading can do that. So there's been many, many, many changes, and you'll see many more changes happening.
Wow. So why do you think that is, that that has been just rapidly changing?
Well, I think they're trying to get it better and more geared toward children, which is really good in some aspects, but not good in others, because some of the programs that we have, kids don't have internets and things at home that they can do the program. They can do it at school, but they can't do it at home because they don't have those kind of things. So it's like a disadvantage for some families.
Okay. So just to put it out there, you are retiring at the end of this year?
After 57 years, I'm retiring at the end of this year.
Wow, yes. 57 years.
It's a long time.
Yeah. She was actually my kindergarten teacher.
Yes.
That was 15 or so years ago?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
So,
And because, Tim, because I've been teaching 57 years, this is really pretty much unusual. So I've been asked to teach at the state teacher's retirement, asked to talk at the state teacher's retirement luncheon in Palmdale, no Lancaster.
Really?
Lancaster, yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, it's unusual for a teacher to teach that long. And looking back at it, I think now if I had it all to do over, I would retire earlier, because then I would have energy to do the kind of things that I really wanted to do that I may not have the energy to do now.
So over the 57 years, what you teach special ed kids first, and then did you get into kindergarten?
Yes. I taught special ed kids first. Then I went to Lancaster, and I moved to California because I was tired of the snow. And then I taught special ed in Lancaster, and then I came to Acton. I've been in Acton over 50 years. I came to Acton and taught one class, and then they needed me in kindergarten, so then I have taught kindergarten since then.
Okay.
I moved over to Title I.
Okay.
And why I moved to Title I is because it's much easier, smaller groups of kids, and then kindergartners are very active, so.
Okay.
Yeah.
What's your favorite to teach?
I didn't have a favorite.
You just?
No, my favorite to teach was kids. I liked working with the individual kids and what they're doing and how they're moving along and giving them some individual attention that sometimes they didn't get.
Wow.
Yeah.
Okay. So what work have you done? What are all the schools that you worked at over 57 years?
Just mostly Acton. most active. And I think I do outside things too. I'm really interested in veterans and homeless veterans. We accumulated backpacks for 10 veterans last year that were homeless. And we provided the backpack with them full of stuff that they needed. In the senior center, I like work going to the senior center, so those are things I'm looking forward to.
Okay, so over the 57 years, you surely have a lot of experience. And that, correct me if I'm wrong, but 50 of those years are within this district?
Yes. Yes, 50 of those are years.
So you've been here in the ups and the downs. And so
yes.
What would you say is the number one thing that we need to do as a community in the school district to...
Let me finish that. What I do think that we need to do as a community is I think the community needs to come and get the things necessary to volunteer in the classroom. Parents need to help their students, teachers work. Maybe they can prep papers. Maybe they can do some helping with kids that need individual reading. I think there's nothing better than to have a classroom full of kids that get to read daily to somebody, whether it's their teacher, whether it's somebody else, just daily. And even now with the kindergarten teacher that I'm working with, those kids get to read daily, which is really, really good.
Okay. So what do you do after you retire? Do you help more with the homeless vets?
I'm going to work more with vets.
Okay.
I'm going to work more with, I'm not really sure, some volunteer things. One of the things that I really like to do, and your grandfather is one of them, World War One veterans, World War Two veterans.
World War Two, yeah.
Well, one of the things that I have done is that you aren't aware of is that I belong to the Museum for World War Two veterans, and I put his name and his brother's name in on the list of veterans that I know, so that it will be in the museum. So,
oh, really?
Yeah.
Well,
yeah.
I'm sure I appreciate that, but I'm sure he would too.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah, he actually just got his medals. He
oh,
got
did
the rest
he?
Of them. Yeah, about a month or two ago.
See, that's nice.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So it's yeah.
See, my hope is that we have a veterans home in Lancaster, and my hope is to be able to go there and volunteer. And see if I can record on cassette, which is old for you, but it would record on this cassette.
Oh, yeah.
Early memories from some of those veterans, because their families aren't aware of what they went through. And I think it would be nice if the family knew what they went through as veterans. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So that's one of the whole things I want to do.
So how long have you been doing that?
I haven't done that at all. I've just been thinking about, I know what I want to do.
Okay, well, let me rephrase.
This is what I have done. We have a Vietnam wall, and on that wall there are some veterans that are from the Antelope Valley. I've pulled those names off, and then I will give them to Pam Willis, who's in charge of that, and she will have an ROTC group when the wall comes again that will announce just the veterans that are on that wall that are from the Antelope Valley. Yeah.
Wow, that's really special. We got to wrap up here.
Okay.
So do you have any final words? Anything you want
to Yes, it plug? Is better. It is better to build a child than try to repair an adult.
Wow.
It's one of the sayings that I have.
Yeah, it's great.
Okay.
I'm sure my mom, I think I've heard you say it before and my mom, so.
Okay.
Um,
thank you for interviewing me.
Oh, well, thanks for sitting down with me.